As you may know, I installed Elementary OS on my laptop a few months ago. During the last few months, I have done many adjustments to make Elementary OS fit my needs. I summarize these adjustments in this video of 15 things to do after installing Elementary OS Uno. Install Firefox. Epiphany, the default web browser of Elementary, is well integrated into the Pantheon desktop environment, but it is inferior to Firefox. From my experience, it fails to play some Full HD videos smoothly, and it lacks some key extensions I use in Firefox. Firefox, on the other hand, has no problems with playing Full HD videos, and has plenty of useful extensions. So the first thing I did in my Elementary OS is I replaced Epiphany with Firefox. Install Twix. Next, I changed many other settings using Terminal or dconf editor. But later, I discovered that you can do all these changes with a nice graphical program, Elementary Twix. So, as a second thing to do after installing Elementary OS, I recommend installing Elementary Twix. To that end, you need to install Software Properties Common, add Elementary Twix repository, update the software list, and install Elementary Twix. You can find all these commands on my website. See the link in the description. Twix will be available in your Elementary menu after the installation. I will show you how to use it in the next things to do after installing Elementary OS. Disable single click. The file manager of Elementary OS uses a single click to open files and folders by default. Some users seem to like this behavior, but I don't. I also believe many new Linux users are used to double-click. So I disable the single-click. This is when Elementary Twix come to play. Go to Twix, Files, and disable single-click. Now you can use your mouse pointer click in a traditional way with one click to select and double-click to open. Disable natural copy-paste in Terminal. Another non-standard behavior of Elementary OS is that by default you can use Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to copy-paste in the terminal. Elementary OS tries to be friendly for new Linux users, and I understand that. However, these shortcuts are not standard, and confusing for users who have some experience of using the terminal. I prefer to use the standard shortcuts, and I think new users should learn them too. So to disable these natural copy-paste shortcuts, and return the standard one, open Twix, and in the Terminal tab, disable Natural Copy-Paste. After that, you will have to use Ctrl-Shift-C and Ctrl-Shift-V to copy and paste in the terminal. The major advantage, you can now use Ctrl-C to interrupt the running process in the terminal. Add Minimize button. Elementary OS has only Close and Maximize buttons by default. The Elementary OS team argues that instead of minimize, you should use the close button and the application should stay preloaded in the memory after you close it. So next time you open it, it opens very fast. But it seems that only the Elementary specific applications behave this way, so I prefer to have the minimize button. To add the minimize button, open Twix again, and in the Appearance tab, select Minimize Left Layout. The Minimize button appears on the left side of the title bar. There are available some other options. You can have buttons like in Windows, macOS, Ubuntu, etc. Disable Group Delay. When you start your Elementary OS, you likely see this group menu. Unless you dual boot and need to switch between Elementary and Windows often, you can disable this menu and speed up your boot by 5 seconds. To disable the group delay, open the group config file and set group timeout to 0. Ctrl-O to save and Ctrl-X to exit. Next, update group. Reboot your system and you won't see the group menu anymore. Your system will boot straight into your Elementary OS without group delay. If you need to see the group menu again, press the escape key during the startup of the system. I also noticed that group timeout set to 0 may not work on some systems if you dual boot with Windows. I tried to fix it with different approaches, including setting group record fail timeout, but it didn't work. As a temporary solution, you can set timeout to 1. You will see group menu for 1 second, which is still less than the default 5 seconds. LibreOffice. As my office of choice, I installed LibreOffice. I believe it is the best office suite for Linux. The latter two packages are required to make LibreOffice look native in Elementary OS. This is how LibreOffice looks in my Elementary OS. If you do not get this look out of the box, navigate to Tools, Options, View, Icon Style, and select Elementary Style here. Install Clipped. After I tried to use Clipboard Manager in Plasma 5, I cannot imagine my computer work without it. In Plasma 5, it is a part of the desktop, but in Elementary, you need to install a third-party app to get the same functionality. I tried different programs and only Clipped works the best in Elementary OS. So install it. Next, I recommend to create a shortcut for this application. Go to the Settings, Keyboard, Shortcuts. Add this command and assign a shortcut for it. I use Ctrl Space. So if I press Ctrl Space, I will see the list of strings I copied recently. I can select the one I need and paste it anywhere. Try this program, I promise you won't imagine your work without it. Install Multimedia Codecs. If you play different media files, you may want to install media codecs for commonly used formats. To copy-paste this command, see the description under this video. Activate Nightlight. Nightlight reduces the blue light emission of your screen at night time. This helps to reduce eye strain and to fall asleep. More and more distros include it by default, and Elementary is not an exception. Just go to the Settings, Display, and activate it. Now your screen will be reddish at night, which is better for your eyes. Install drivers. There are different ways to install the essential drivers. The easiest way is to run this command, and it will help you to install all the necessary drivers. My system doesn't require any proprietary drivers, so I cannot show you all possible options here. Please share your experience with installing the drivers this way in the comment section below. I think many users will greatly appreciate that. Install GDebi. GDebi helps to install Debian packages with a graphical interface. This is also not what I do on my system, because I am fine with using the command line. However, I know that many Linux users prefer installing programs with a graphical interface. So if you will need to install some non-official programs in dev packages, you would like to have GDebi. Install it and test it with any dev package. For example, you can try installing Skype. Also, I recommend using Skype for web. I review it in this video. Improve laptop battery life. I use Elementary OS on a laptop, so I install TLP package that reduces the amount of running tasks in the background and thus extends the battery life. You just need to install it and forget about it. I install it on my Acer Swift 1 laptop, and I get the battery life of 6 to 8 hours, which is comparable to what I had with Windows on this laptop. Enable tray icons for third-party apps. Dropbox and some other third-party programs, such as Skype for example, use some outdated code for their tray icons, and this code is not compatible with Elementary OS Uno, so you won't see the tray icon. To fix this incompatibility, you first need to edit the indicator application by adding Pantheon to this line, then install the old panel indicator by downloading it from Launchpad.net, you will find the link in the description, and installing it. Now log out and log in. Dropbox icon is visible in the system tray now. This should enable tray icons for other apps that use the older tray icon code. Install Synaptic. Although its interface is not the prettiest, Synaptic is extremely reliable and powerful software manager. You can see the real package name here, instead of user-friendly names you see in the elementary software center. You can also find more advanced information about a program. For example, you can see all the dependencies. So, if you want to have access to more advanced features in your software manager, install Synaptic. This was the list of 15 things to do after installing Elementary OS. I hope it was useful. Let me know what you do after you install Elementary OS. I will add the most useful things to the blog post which accompanies this video. Thank you for watching!